So in the last couple of Ask Travis videos, there's been several people asked for a bookshelf tour. All honestly, I don't watch booktubers. I don't hate them, I just don't watch them. So I didn't know what a bookshelf tour was, but I looked into it. Apparently I just show you my books. So we can do that. So it is time for a bookshelf tour. Yay. All right, so we're gonna start with my big bookshelf. This is the one that I built myself, I guess about a year ago. I really wanna rebuild it because now I have actual proper tools, but that's neither here nor there. Now before we get started, when I was watching other bookshelf tours, people had like organizational systems. My organization system is that I put authors together and I put series together. After that, not so much. Over here in the top left corner, and this is where I have the Hunger Games trilogy. I love the first book, not a big fan of the second two. I have World War Z. I haven't read it yet. I really need to, I just haven't. We have the Artemis Fowl series. It is the complete series, and I even have the little Artemis Fowl Files book. I made a review of this, and I'll say it again, this is my second favorite YA series ever. It's absolutely amazing. Now moving along, we have a radio with an iPod dock. I'll play music on it every once in a while. And we have Lego Fireman. This tree is on fire, and an alien is putting it out because aliens are good firefighters, and he has an axe because axe. Next to the Lego firefighters, we have my J.K. Rowling section, I guess you would call it. We have the two Robert Galbraith books, the Cormoran Strike books, and then the Harry Potter books. You can tell where I got into the series because that's where the hardback books came in. This is the first Harry Potter book I got. I got it when I was in the third grade, Chamber of Secrets. Obviously, I love Harry Potter. I've said that a million times. And this is a chocolate frog box and my Dumbledore card from Harry Potter World. I do have the complete series, obviously. I have two of the Half-Blood Princes. One is the Bloomsbury English edition that my sister brought back to me from London when she went there. And then I also have the Tales of the Beetle and the Bard, the two Hogwarts library books, Quidditch of the Ages and Fantastic Beasts, where to find them. And then I have two kind of companion type reference books written by other people about the world of Harry Potter. They're kind of interesting, actually. All right, so let's move on over to the second shelf. We're gonna start with, and now we have another trilogy to start this shelf off with. This is the Abortion Trilogy or Old Kingdom series. I absolutely love this series. There's supposed to be another book coming out called Clario, but it's been rumored to be coming out for about 5 years now, and it keeps getting pushed back. So I don't know if it'll actually ever come out. Like I said at the beginning, I like to keep authors together, so we also have more Garth Nix books. This is the Seventh Tower series. This was one of my absolute favorite series when I was in middle school. I loved this series to death. I started when the first book came out and picked all of them up. They didn't come out in hardback, they were paperback originals. So these are actually all the first edition, except for this one, because somewhere along the line, I lost the second book. And you can tell by how worn they are that I've read them many, many times. The Keys to the Kingdom by Garth Nix, I've tried to get into a couple times and never really enjoyed it. Ender's Game, obviously one of my favorite books ever, helped inspire Bridgeworld. The Chronicles of Narnia, this is the entire series. I haven't read it since I was a freshman in college, but it's definitely a kid's series. I don't know if I'll ever reread it. I probably will at some point. And also by C.S. Lewis, The Great Divorce, which I haven't read. Then we have Holes, which was a really fantastic book. I haven't read it in many, many years, but I have read it a couple times. Came out when I was in the fifth grade. Witch, which is really kind of an elementary school age book. It's actually a really, really good book. I enjoyed it. I've read it a couple times. When I was young, I reread books constantly. I very rarely read a new book, so I had a library of about 30 books or so, and I just kept rereading them. This is the book that got me started thinking about Bridgeworld and where the premise for Bridgeworld came from. It's a boy who finds out him and a large chunk of his community are actually aliens. And when I was thinking about this book, I was wondering what it would be like if he had to go back to his alien world. And that's where the idea for Bridgeworld came to me. Then we have The Outsiders by S.E. Hinton, all-time classic. The Smugglers, another really good book, a YA book. Read it a couple times because it was in that library of 30 or 40 books that I kept reading. Flash Forward, I haven't read this one I think I got this when Borders was going out of business and I rated it. I know I got Josie Wells from when Borders was going out of business. And every book in there was like a dollar. This is my dad's favorite movie, so I figured I'd get the book. I haven't read it yet. End of the Line, another Borders raid book. I think this one's a collection. Yeah, this is a collection. I need to read it, just haven't gotten around to it. Iron River, haven't read. My Teacher Fried My Brains. This was a really cute book. I read this in elementary school. I think just once. It was amusing. Wonderful Years. I found this at my mom's house, I think, and I just took it. I haven't read it yet. Sleep Eaters, a sci-fi book I bought and just haven't gotten around to reading it. War and Peace. My mom actually bought this as like, ha, I bet you won't read this. I will eventually. I just haven't yet because it's a huge book. So I know it'll take, you know, at least 3, 4, 5 weeks to read. So I want to make sure that I've read everything that I want to read before I start on that thing. Sybil, I haven't read yet, although it's very famous. Strangers in a Strange Land, I haven't read yet. City Underground. This was actually a really cute book, I guess you would say. It was good. It's an old sci-fi. It's from about the 50s. It's definitely like a pre-teenage book. God Smuggler, I don't know where that came from. Doomsday Wing, this was an alright book. It wasn't anything special. Another old book, I think this one was from the 60s. One of the amusing things about this book is it was chock full of typos. It came out from a smaller press, so it's good to see that things haven't really changed in all those years. Then we have the Game of Thrones or Song of Ice and Fire books that I have. Game of Thrones I made a review of. Dance with Dragons, Feast for Crows. I haven't read any but the first one. I'm going to at some point. So now we're into the beginning of my Dean Koontz collection. This is A Big Little Life. This is the book that he actually sent to me. It's autographed, yeah, to Travis Wolf, Dean Koontz. That's a really kind of a touching story about his dog who died. And it touched me because I've had a dog who died and that ain't cool. It sucks. We can see my Dean Koontz collection. I have a lot of repeats in here because I bought a box of books off of eBay of his. It had like 20 or 30 books in it. Some of them were overlapping with books I already had. Notable selections from this is StarQuest, which is the first book that he published. Came out in 68, I believe. The cool thing about this book is that it's an ace double, if you'll see up here. Now what that means is you have the book, but if you take it, you flip it over, there's another book, and they meet in the middle, and then eventually, when you get to the end, you can see the text will be upside down, so that's when you flip over, read the other book. So you get two books for the price of one. But I also have the writer's biography by Catherine Ramsland. It was an all right read, but basically most of the books, she just summarized Koontz's books, so that got a little annoying because I had to keep skipping through it, obviously, so I wouldn't hit a bunch of spoilers. Now moving down, we have more Koontz books. Once again, I got a bunch of them from one big box. I've read most of them. I think there's two or three left that I haven't read. And we have one of my portable typewriters. This is an old Royal in the letter that Koontz wrote to me. And now we have more books. Sparrows in the Scullery. It was an all right book when I was little. I tried to reread it recently. It didn't hold up. Choke by Chuck Palahniuk, or whatever you pronounce his name. I didn't like it. So the people that asked about him, the first book I read, I didn't like. So that's not a good sign. I might try to read more of his later. I just didn't like this one. I'm not a big fan of the minimalism, nothing really happening in the plot books. And that's definitely what this was. Dracula, classic Dracula. It was good, but it was spoiled by the fact that Dracula is such a known figure for me that all of the mystery was missing out of the book, where a lot of the driving force would have been curiosity, naturally. Veronica Roth's Divergent, I didn't like it. So, I've said that a couple times now, but I just didn't like it. Red April, haven't read. June 6, 1944. The Voice of D-Day, I haven't read. Turgenev, Fathers and Sons. I had to read this book for a Russian history class I took in college. I didn't like this book very much at all. It dealt with nihilism, which I'm not a fan of. So, that. Whiskey River, haven't read. These two books my mom gave me because I was reading too much Stephen King, she said, and she wanted me to read them. I haven't read them. Not yet. A Long Shadow. I started, it bored me, so I quit. 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea by Jules Verne. This is an awesome, awesome book. It's amazing how much came true from these books. Jules Verne, I mean, there's people that worship him, and they worship him for a reason. H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds. I haven't read this one yet. I'm going to get around to it. My James Bond series, it's not complete. I only have six of the books. I've read them all, but the reason I don't have the complete series is because for some reason these books are $15 a pop, which does not make any sense because they're just skinny little paperback books. The ones I have, I actually bought when Borders was going out of business. Zamyatin's We. This was a really good book. This is a dystopian book in the vein of 1984 in a way. I had to read it for that same Russian history class. I really enjoyed this one. Swiss Family Robinson. I loved the Disney movie growing up, and the book was pretty much just as good. It was a good book. The Wonderful Wizard of Oz. I haven't gotten around to reading yet. 1984. I really enjoyed. Harold and Maude. I haven't read yet. Gilgamesh. I read in high school. I haven't read this actual copy, but I've read it. Wuthering Heights, haven't read yet. Under the Lake, haven't read yet. And then we have the Giver series, I guess you would call it, by Lois Lowry. The first two books, the first book I loved, loved, loved. It was one of my favorite dystopian books ever. Gathering Blue was pretty good. Messenger and Son, I hated. I thought they were awful. King James Version of the Bible. I've read that one all the way through, read the NIV all the way through. Don't try and guess about my religion though, because I'm not going to be talking about that. The Invisible Man by H.G. Wells. Haven't read this one yet. The Time Machine by H.G. Wells. Why are one of my Wells books off on its own? Oh well. The Time Machine was a really good book after I got past the first five or six pages. The writing was really pretentious to start with, but once the story got going, he calmed down on it, so it was good. Wizard's Hall I made a review of. It's like a Harry Potter ripoff, or Harry Potter ripped this one off because it's older. Not the Usual Kind of Girl. Haven't read yet. The K was a good book, and A Boy at War was a good book. So moving down the shelf. We have The Hobbit, Lord of the Rings, and Shaping Middle Earth. So my Tolkien area, and then we got the One Ring sitting down here with them. Lost Years of Merlin series. I absolutely loved this series growing up, but I tried to reread it, I don't know, a year or two ago. I was making reviews of them as I read them. I got through the first two books just fine, but the third one, I got fed up and I quit. It doesn't hold up well. It doesn't have a lot of crossover for adults. And there was one character in the book that I quit that was just annoying the ever-loving crap out of me. So I quit reading them. But I absolutely loved them growing up. I should probably try to finish the last two books in it. The Once and Future King, a classic, really good book. This is the Camelot series by Jack White. The first two books are absolutely phenomenal. I love them to death. The third book, it starts to get a little wordy and slow, and the characters start going into soliloquies. Really, really long soliloquies every couple of pages. I got through the third book. I've actually read it a couple times, but the fourth book, the soliloquies get even worse. So I've tried twice to get through the fourth book and haven't got through them either time. I'm not the only one that says this about the series. I've looked online and seen reviews. So yeah, it gets annoying. I made the mistake of going ahead and buying the rest of the books after I read the first two and absolutely loved them. So I figured I would read them all, and I just haven't. And I probably never will. The Seeing Stone is another King Arthur book, a really good book. The Acts of King Arthur and His Knights, that's a really good book by John Steinbeck. The Illyrian Destiny, this is actually a book that my mom brought home for me because he was at a bookstore doing a signing. She brought this back when I was like fourth or fifth grade. It was an okay book, I guess, but it was very poorly written, which makes sense because it was a teenager that wrote it. It actually came out through a vanity press. So I've learned all of this long since I read it. The first time I read it, I was like, yeah, that's a decent book. Rifles for Wadi, that's a really, really good book. It's about the Civil War. The American Civil War for all my foreign people. The 10,000 I haven't read. Cowboys and Angels haven't read. True Grit, I read. This was an awesome book. This has been adapted twice in the movies. Once John Wayne, you know, guy with the eye patch. The Fault in Our Stars by Green, reviewed. This is my only James Patterson book because I didn't know who James Patterson was when I picked it up. I just saw a bunch of his books and there's posters of him everywhere, so I was like, okay, I'll give this guy a read. Might be like another Stephen King. I read it, like, yeah, that's a decent book. Then I looked him up on Wikipedia, because that's what I do, just look into writers. And I learned about his practice of not actually writing books, so I boycott him now. So that's the only book I have of his. Strongheart, I haven't read. Merlin, I haven't read. Baa Black Sheep, I loved this TV show. I don't know if this is like the TV show. This is by the actual guy. It's like his autobiography. I haven't read it yet, though. The Atlantic World in the Age of Empire. I think this is one of my old textbooks. Psycho-Historical Crisis. I tried several times to read this when I was very young. It came off as just wordy and pretentious back then, but I mean, I was 9 or 10 years old. I should probably try to read it again, see if it's any good. I got a little bit of Harry Potter memorabilia, butter beer mug with some Bertie Bott's Every Flavor beans left over. Got that from Harry Potter World. My quick quotes quill in the notepad, a wand. And then over here we have a good little chunk of Star Wars books. I've read most of them. Actually, I think I've read them all. The one that really stands out is The Darth Maul Shadow Hunter by Michael Reeves. This was an awesome, awesome book. I've read it 2 or 3 times. We also have 2 of my books because I think I just had extra books, so I stuck them over here. Didn't know where else to put them. Clive Cussler Iceberg, I've read a couple of times. Once just for pleasure and once for summer reading. Another Clive Cussler book, The Spy, which I haven't read yet. So moving down to the bottom shelf, I have my little romance section, I guess you would call it. This was a book that came out from my first publisher, and I just wanted to see how they did with books, so I bought that to see the quality of books my publisher was going to make. Then we got several Nicholas Sparks books. I'm not going to lie, I enjoy Nicholas Sparks for the most part. There's only one of his books I've ever read that I was like, man, that wasn't very good, which was The Rescue, incidentally. They're very good books, so not ashamed. The Twilight Trilogy. I've read the first one, obviously, and made a review of it. I borrowed these from my sister and just haven't given them back. I've only read the first one. I haven't read the other two. Ivan's War. This was another book I had to read for my Russian history class. It's about World War II from the Soviet perspective. Very, very good book if you like history. Very informative, obviously, because I read it for a Russian history class. Unknown, I haven't read yet. The Gilded Seal, I haven't read. Soldier Boys, this was a very, very touching book. It's a YA, kind of middle grade book. Very sad ending. Good book, very good book. Fahrenheit 451, obviously, I enjoy quite a bit. Willow Hill, I haven't read. Nothing But the Truth by Avi. I read this many, many, many years ago. I must have been 8 years old. I enjoyed it back then. I can't really give a valid opinion of it now. And we got Robert Ludlum's The Born Identity. I bought this from an antique store for like $3. Because I really like the movies. So I just haven't read this one yet because I only got it about a week or two ago. I got a couple books acting as bookends. The Last Full Measure by Jeff Sahara, I haven't read yet. The First Heroes, I haven't read. Both about World War II, I believe. The bottom one's about the Civil War, yeah. Now we have my John D. McDonald collection. I bought all of these books in one go from a box on eBay. It's the best way to buy books, just buy a collection. I got all of these books for about $20. I think there's 34 of them. From here on are the Travis McGee series. I've read 2 of those, and I've only read 1 other book of his that wasn't a Travis McGee novel. And I enjoyed that one a lot more than the Travis McGee series, in all honesty. I haven't read a lot of John D. McDonald. I'm working on it, though. We have my John Grisham collection. I've read all of these books, enjoyed them all. The best one was The Firm, which was his breakthrough book. It was an awesome, awesome book. The only one I didn't really like was The Chamber, which I didn't even finish. It was just got really slow. It's also a big book, and nothing was happening, so I just quit reading it. I have a pocket history of the United States. Took this from my mom. Just a textbook. This was my Russian history textbook. So, once you're in college, you get to either keep your textbooks or sell them back for 5% of what you paid for them, so I usually just kept them. All right, so now we're going to go from that bookshelf to my bookshelf that you see in my book reviews. Top shelf, we have my books, or at least some of them. First 2 Bridge Worlds, 2 Triton books, and then A Midnight Stroll, my short story collection. Moving down to that, we have the first shelf of my Stephen King collection. This is the one area where I actually organize my books in somewhat of a system. I put them in chronological order. My Stephen King collection is pretty much complete. I think I am missing 2 or 3 of his books, and I've read pretty much all the ones that I own. Moving down to the second shelf, once again, solid Stephen King. You can see where I became a Stephen King fan, because that's where the books start being in hardcover. This is On Writing by Stephen King. It's the Bible for writers. It's amazing, amazing book. If you like to write, you need to read this book. So moving down to my third shelf, we have even more Stephen King. Now some of these aren't in chronological order. I just need to go through and put them back in, because I got these books somewhat recently and just haven't gotten around to putting them in order. Desperation is the one book in my collection that I haven't read of his yet. Well, I haven't read the Tommyknockers either. So there's 2 books left that I haven't read yet. This one's actually like an old school library edition. It's kind of cool. It has a hardcover to it, but it's paperback size. So that's kind of nifty. It still has the Dewey Decimal System sticker on it. And finally, moving out of Stephen King, we have Kyle Mills' Lord of Corruption. A pretty decent book. James Grippando's Money to Burn, I made a review of. We have the Emperor series by Conna Golden. Absolutely love this series. It made my top 5 books of all time. I love, love, love this series so much. You can tell how much I love them because of how worn the books are. This was in that 40 or 50 books that I read every year over and over again. And he recently released The Blood of Gods, which is, he says it's not part of the series, but it really is. It's just a follow-up. That this book just covers the Civil War after Caesar was assassinated. Then we have the Genghis series, also by Conna Golden. This followed the rise of the Mongol Empire all the way through Kublai Khan. Very good series. I didn't like it as much as the Emperor series, though. So the last shelf, we have like 30 Forbes magazines, because they tricked me into subscribing. I had read a couple articles on the web pages, and I was like, maybe I might like one of their magazines. And I went on the web page, and they said, oh, you can get one for free sent to your house. I was like, okay, so I put my address in and got one free. And the next thing I know, they had signed me up, and I had to end up paying for it. I read them all. I didn't really enjoy them very much, but if I pay for something, I'm gonna read it. We have a dictionary holding them up. And then we have a couple reference books. This is The Elements of Style, which is supposed to be one of the best books on writing. Really all this book is, it's a list of rules. If you have questions about, apostrophe S, what do you put it on the end of multiple, or do you just put another apostrophe on? And a bunch of little stuff like that. The Cambridge Latin course. This was my Latin textbook in high school, my Latin 1 textbook, and I ended up buying it just so I could refresh on my Latin. And it is the best way to learn a language by far. Because all it is a storybook, and it gives you the words, and then you just learn to read naturally. So the servant is in the garden. The servant is working in the garden. That's Clemens. He's a servant. That's Grumio. Anybody that's read these books, they know all about Grumio. Grumio Anquilam Dilectat. Then we have a Latin and English dictionary and another dictionary. So that was my bookshelf tour. I hope you enjoyed it. If not, whatever. You're probably not even watching this, because you probably already clicked away. But thanks for watching, and until next time, keep reading.